All right, the football season is over. Alabama's celebrated their national championship with the parade they had this past week, and now it's time to look ahead. It's onward. You know, Nick Saban, he doesn't like to celebrate those victories. It's always looking ahead, and it starts with the coaching staff. The latest announcement's coming down, Mike Locksley getting promoted to offensive coordinator. Not yet sure if that's going to be a co-offensive coordinator or what that's going to entail, but I want to start with him first. You know, he was obviously with the wide receivers. I had the chance to talk to him at the national championship. It's crazy. He's actually trained my trainer. He worked with him at Maryland. He was a coach there. Mm-hmm. So I got some insight from my trainer about Mike Locksley as a person, as a coach, and really just talking to him. I really like his philosophy, kind of his coaching mentality through all that. So, Kevin, just from your standpoint, why do you think Mike Locksley is the guy to run this offense for Alabama?
Well, he's an impressive individual. I know you were impressed by him and the time you spent around him, and then digging into his background a little bit. He's been a successful offensive coordinator. If you look at the numbers at some of the places he's been, like Maryland, like Illinois, he's done a nice job. He wasn't as successful as a head coach, but we won't go there. But he's not hired to be the head coach. He's hired to run the offense. This is a little unusual for Nick Saban because he typically doesn't hire from within. Steve Sarkisian was an internal hire. He went from analyst to offensive coordinator. Didn't stay very long. Mike Locksley went from analyst to position coach to offensive coordinator. Typically, Nick Saban goes outside the Alabama family to bring in his offensive coordinators. And at this point, you know, he's won national championships with four different offensive coordinators at Alabama. And some people might think, well, you could stick a crash test dummy in that position and they would still have success with all the talent. That's not the case. And it's unfair to the guys who have done that job and done it well. And I think Mike Locksley will continue that tradition. And here's the one key area where I think he may be best qualified out of anyone he could have hired. They're going to have a very interesting quarterback competition, battle, controversy come the spring. And maybe beyond, maybe into the fall, maybe into the season. Mm-hmm. How do they handle that? The players have to be convinced that the coaches are making the decision that is best for the team. The last thing you want is people taking sides. You don't want to have a Tua camp and a Jalen camp, and that leads to dissension, and then you don't play your best football, and all of a sudden you lose more than a single game in the regular season for the first time in forever. So I think Mike Locksley is uniquely positioned to help sell that decision to the players. Mm-hmm. They have his respect already.
Yeah.
You saw the campaigning for him to get this job from some of the players on social media.
Oh yeah.
And some of the team leaders like Damian Harris.
Yep.
When Damian Harris speaks, Nick Saban listens.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not true for everyone. He listens to all of his players, but some players more than others, and Damian is at the top of the list. For them to go out on a limb for Mike Locksley said a lot about what they think about him. And I think when they make this decision, however they're going to divide the quarterback reps come the fall, I think Mike Locksley being the OC, helping to make the decision in the first place, although ultimately it'll be Nick Saban's call, but then selling it to the players, I think he's perfect for that role.
Yeah, I think he's really garnered a lot of respect from them. Earlier in the offseason, he lost his son, and that was something that, you know, was a big story. And, you know, coming back from that and be able to coach the team and to use some of that adversity and what he went through, you can tell that he really has garnered a lot of respect from the entire team. So I certainly think it's a good fit as well. Now you add some other guys, Josh Gattis from Penn State, Pete Golding coming in from UTSA, some other younger guys on the list here that we had is Carl Scott as well as Jeff Banks. So first of all, there's kind of a trend there. Most of these guys in their 30s still, so there's some youth to this coaching staff. At this point, we still don't know necessarily what the titles will entail for these guys. But why Saban? What do you think the justification in going for some of these younger guys under Coach Saban?
Well, if there's a thread here, I think the oldest guy of the new guys coming in from the outside is Jeff Banks. I believe he's 42. He'll be the special teams coach. I think if there's a thread among all of these guys, it's their outstanding reputations as recruiters.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Nick Saban has never wavered from that. He always wants assistant coaches who can get out there and find talent and develop relationships to get that talent to Tuscaloosa.
Mm-hmm.
So that hasn't changed, but it's interesting. They've been number one in recruiting for however many years in a row now. We've all lost count. But it almost, people are saying, well, they're slipping a little bit this year. Well, they don't have as many scholarships to give for one thing. But slippage is all relative, and from their regard, it's not much. But to go from the number one class to, say, the number five class, or wherever they might end up, that's not going to make Nick Saban happy. These guys are known as recruiters. Doesn't mean they aren't good on-the-field coaches. Josh Gattis, especially at Penn State, has a really good rep in that regard, as well as his reputation as a recruiter. But I think Nick Saban also likes the idea of fresh energy, fresh enthusiasm, fresh ideas. And that is part of what keeps him going.
Yeah, so Saban doesn't have to get our Twitter account. He just lets everybody else do all the social media for him.
And he has to now because his biggest job is coaching the coaches. Mm-hmm. It's any head coach's job. You coach your assistants. So now he's got to mold that group into a cohesive unit. He's got to have confidence in them and trust in them, and he's got to make sure the players have trust in them as well. So this is a new challenge for him. You say, how does he keep going? Why does he keep doing this? How many more times can he have a parade? How many more parades will satisfy him? But now he has a greater challenge because now he has to mold a significantly different coaching staff into a staff that can go out and compete and get back to the playoff for a fifth straight year and maybe win his sixth national championship at Alabama, his seventh overall.
Okay, Kevin, and my final question for you, is there any concern at all? There's so much turnover here, and obviously the last couple of years we've seen turnovers at the coordinator positions, not both in the same year per se, but is there a bit of concern that we've seen so much turnover for this Alabama team this year?
I don't think so. And again, why are the people leaving? You have to look at that. Well, Jeremy Pruitt left because he's becoming a head coach in the SEC. Uh-huh. Now, not everyone got that kind of opportunity that left the staff. But turnover is never a bad thing, and Nick Saban has never shied away from it. He's typically had multiple positions come open on his staff every year. Like you said, I believe this is the first time in his tenure at Alabama that they've had to replace both coordinators, so that'll be a new experience for him.
Yeah.
But he doesn't mind bringing in new guys, and he's always, this goes back to his time at LSU, he's always liked young, hungry, enthusiastic guys who want to prove themselves. That was Kirby Smart's MO when he joined the LSU staff in 2004. So he's never shied away from that, and I don't think it's going to be a problem this time. Again, people are leaving because in most cases, they're getting better opportunities. And some people just don't want to work for Nick Saban forever. They like to take what they learn from him and then apply it somewhere else.
And we saw that with Kirby Smart this past season as they went head-to-head in the national championship. Nick Saban, though, coming up on top of that. All right, for all your Alabama Crimson Tide updates and as we get closer to national signing day, the real national signing day, and, of course, as we get more information on the coaching changes, we'll keep you up to date. You can visit us on AL.com.